Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video I'll be opening and assembling the poly bag from Lego Explore magazine issue number 32, which is Lego set 11978, and it's a Viking ship. I haven't done any videos for a couple of weeks due to other commitments, so I do apologise to my regular followers, and there may be a few weeks over this month, but I will be posting as often as I can. I'd like to say hello to thank Stodge the Fleet for a like on Instagram, and Sheffy Bloke, again, thank you very much. So this is Lego Explore magazine issue number 32, which is the reason you're probably watching this video. As you see, there's two builds on it. This is the polar bear, is a build from another from a previous magazine. If you watch my videos, you will have seen me build that one. I won't be building that one in this video, but on this one you've got a Viking ship. The magazine is pretty much what it normally is, like loads of Lego builds, instructions, and stuff like that. But I will be posting the instructions to this on my Instagram as well. But having gone through the magazine this month, I have noticed there isn't anything in here for next month, which I do find quite weird. So this could be the last one they're doing. But there could be lots of reasons for that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut this bag off very carefully with the scissors. Like so. If you're after the instructions of this build here, they are on this little scanny thing here. I forget the name of it, but I do use them a couple of times. So we'll put the magazine over here and we'll get on with this one. I'm forgetting myself. I need to. So this is the Lego poly bag 11978, as I said before, the Viking ship. So there we go. This does look a really, really nice little build. I have noticed that I've looked at a few of the other magazines, and the other magazines that they go for less money. And they usually come with probably a few simpler builds, but they also come with a figure as they usually come with a figure as well, especially the Lego City magazine. So I'm not really sure what's going. If this magazine is suffering, that could be the reason why. Because at the price point of, say, I think it's six, seven. Let's see what it is now. It's £7. And you get a little build like this, and the Lego City magazine comes with a vehicle and a figure for £5. So that might be it, but that's another story for another day. We'll get on with this build here. So we start off with a brown 8x2 base plate, which is this one here. We have a cream 2x2 round brick, which goes on there like so. Then we have two of these black 2x1 with all these studs on it. They go on each end like so. That's what we should have. And next we make the sides of the ship. So that starts off with a black one by four base plate, which is one of these. But I'm going to be doing this together, as you'll see here. Put them like this, and then we have a light blue 2x1 base plate, which goes in the middle of the black base plate like so. So I've done that twice. Have two of these brown 3x1 curved roofing pieces, or two on each piece. So it looks like that. I've done that twice. And then we have a black 2x1 base plate with a 4x1 molded onto the side at a right angle. Try and show you that. That goes on there like so. I can hold that. Then you have a white round flat stud and a red round flat stud. Let's go on the sides. I'll show you this in a minute. Goes on the side like that. That's probably their like clan colours. And next we have four of these, what I call the aircraft guidance pieces, because that's what I remember them as. Four of these as oars. I've done these wrong. I have put these on the wrong side. These two round flat studs go on the two piece rather than on the two side rather than the. Next, you put four of these baton pieces on here. Or these could be the oars for the ship. Just doing this twice. So it should look like that. And these attach on the sides of these pieces here. Like so. As you see, it's starting to take shape as a boat now. Next we have four of the brown cheese pieces, which are these little triangular pieces here. These go on the sides here to make the boat shape, on the front and the back. They go on like so. I'll try and show you that. Next we have two black 2x1 cheese pieces. Cheese because they're shaped in a triangle. Then you have a gold 2x1 with a male connector bar, goes onto a brown 2x2 curved roofing piece. Like one of these, these two go together like so. Got to do this twice. And and these bits go on the end, like so. Next you put, there's a dragon head on each side. These are nice pieces. I suspect these come from Ninjago. But to put these on here, we attach a 1x1, gold 1x1 with a female connector hook on it. These are really good pieces to have, actually. You can do quite a lot with them. Like if they ever start doing like lots of Dungeons and Dragons stuff, you could make mini dragons with those. That'd be quite handy. Next, we make the sail, which is two of these Technic connector pieces, three two red axle Technic red axles. So these go in like so. Then you put another one on like that and another axle. Then you have a Technic piece here. I'm not sure what it is, but it's like a T piece with a cross connector on it. And that goes on there like so. And that goes on there like that. Next, you make the piece for the sail, which is a 4x4 curved flat piece, which is usually used as a bonnet, and a white 2x1. Base plate with two female connector hooks on it. And that goes on there like that. And there we have our Viking ship. It does look quite good. I'm not sure why the sail faces that way. If it's being rowed, I'm not 100% if it's being... I would say it probably looks better like that, but I'm quite sure Lego know what they're doing with this. So unless the sail's been blown around in a storm, which we'll assume it is. Oops. Obviously it's very brittle, so you don't want to push it too hard. I don't think this is a nice build, but it's definitely not the best build they've done, because most of the builds they do are pretty solid. And as you just witnessed there, this one isn't really, but I do think it's got some potential though, so I'm not gonna write it off, so we'll put it back as the instructions say. But there we go, we've got our ship here. It doesn't look too bad, it's got potential. It's got potential. You could do, most of these builds, I personally would actually modify a little bit, to be honest with you. I would always modify these just to do a bit more with them. There is a space where you could put, you could make it like a mini Viking ship, and because you could sit a couple of Vikings in there as well. though what they would be, I don't know. But to be honest with you, that's probably what I would do with it. Or just some other modifications, you could use it as a sort of like something from Pirates of the Caribbean as well. Maybe take the dragon bits off and a few less oars. I don't know. It's not a bad little build. It does have potential, and I could see a lot of rebuild and modification potential, which I think that's what this magazine really is all about. It's encouraging younger builders to actually build more with it. So I personally, if I had the space, I'd probably put this on a shelf in it, because it does look quite nice. It does look quite nice, but it's not really a piece you could really play with or do a lot with, I don't think, as it is. But with some modifications, you definitely could. And if I had the time, I definitely would. So well done, Lego. And I do hope this magazine is going to keep coming out, but due to the fact that they haven't put anything on saying, because they usually got the next build on there, so which they haven't done this time, which is a bit 50-50. But for the meantime, we'll go with it. If not, I've got loads of Lego that still to come on the channel. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, do feel free to like, share, and subscribe. If you have any comments or feedback on this video, do feel free to add them at the end of the video, and I'll try to mention all my upcoming videos. I am on YouTube and Instagram if you wish to follow me. Stay safe, keep building, and hope to see you on my next video. Thank you for watching.